Heller, Merry Christmas. I feel worse today than I did yesterday. Yay. I just woke up with a really bad headache. I remember Evan saying, "What time do you want to go out, you know, to see Nana?" And I was like, maybe about 10 o'clock. And he said, "Oh, well, I was thinking I could just walk down there now." And I was like, "Well, good. And you can go." Actually, I was like, "Yay." And he said, "Why did you say yay like that?" I said, "Because I was thinking if you go ahead and walk down there, then I don't have to go." So, I remember hearing the door slam. And then I woke up on my own about 10 o'clock. And I called my mother, wished her Merry Christmas, and told her I was feeling like shit, so I don't think I'll be coming out today. Then I called my grandmother. I love my grandmama, y'all. I was like, "Hello." She said, "Hello." I said, "Well, I was calling to tell you that I'm not feeling well today, so I'm not coming out." And she said, "Okay, how's the babe?" Because that's what she calls me. And I said, "This is Angelica." And she said, "What?" I said, "This is," you know, I was yelling, "This is Angelica." She said, "Oh, I thought you were Evan." Now, my voice is not that deep, you know. Whatever. I was like, "Okay, well, I'm not coming out today. I just wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas." She said, "Well, where is Evan?" I said, "I guess he's at my mom's house." And she said, "Well, okay, if I see him, I'll, give him something." And I was like, "Okay. Well, I'll talk to you later." And then I called my mom back just to tell her how her mom was... Okay. God, every time I close my eye, it feels like it's sticking. It doesn't want to open again. So, basically, my Christmas present is a massive headache, for which I took some Excedrin migraine, and then I also drank some more of that Alka-Seltzer stuff. Thank you, Jesus, that it is not in my chest, that I don't have any chest congestion. And let's keep it that way, please. Thank you. Amen. What was I saying? I don't know. We went out, and, well, I went out and started the car at like 9 p.m. Evan had gone to another place with my cousin and her baby daddy. And he's like, "I ate with white people." I said, "Okay, how was the food?" He said, "The only thing I liked was the rolls." He said, "And then there were these two little girls, they were so rude." I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Well, one of them walked in and she said, is my Nana in here?" And I said, "No." And she just turned around and walked off. And the other little girl came in and said, "What are y'all watching?" And I said, "Wipeout, do you watch that?" And she said, "No." And she turned around and walked off. I said, "Evan, that's how little kids are. Unless they've been trained to say, hello, how are you, and stuff like that, that's how they are. They're just thinking about what they want. They're not." He's like, "Well, they were rude." I was like, "Well, you were like that when you were little. So, you know, shut up." But it's so funny to me how he gets so irritated at little kids. But when he was younger, he was really good with, you know, I used to babysit, and he was really good with the babies, and he's always been really good with little kids, and he's always real good with his younger cousin, who I think is 9. I don't remember. But, you know, they're the ones who look like brothers, and so he'll help Mike with his homework and stuff like that, and, you know, he plays Madden with him and all the other video games. And so they have a lot, they have a good time, but you know, Mike is black. You know, he's been trained just like I was trained when I was a kid. You know, when you go somewhere, you say hello to people, and you don't just come in and say you're whatever you want and then walk out. You, how are you? Stuff like that. But you know, he doesn't realize children have to be trained how to act. If you don't train your child how to act, then they won't know. They'll never know. Just like when I was a teenager, I would just come in and say, when I moved down here, I would just come in and say whatever I wanted and then walk out. My mother would say I was so rude, and I'm like, whatever. But now I understand because, you know, now it gets on my nerves when, you know, we stop by the bank and Evan is driving and the chick, the teller says, how are you today? And he doesn't say anything. I'm like, Evan, she just spoke to you. Speak back. So I just think it's funny how he reacts to that. How my mother used to get really irritated with me, and I'm like, whatever, I don't care. But, you know, that's Evan. But anyway, I just wanted to say Merry Christmas and stuff. My headache is going away, so I'm going to get back in bed and watch my Fringe marathon. Yesterday I watched the Firefly marathon. I'm gonna be in bed under them covers. 73 degrees in here, but my fingers are cold. So, thank God, this angle really does not look good for my double chin. How's that? Hey, how are you? Yeah, I tilt my head like this, and I'm more straight up and down. But, whatever. I'm going back to bed. Bye.